my channel. Myself Priyanka Sutravi. So today I'm here to cover a few topics like how to get your address proof, next how to get your photo ID, how to get your health card, how to get your bank account. Okay, and while going to get these things, what all documents you need to carry while going there. Okay, and doing prior to that, what you should go do before, like to go on time over there. Okay, so to go on time to a certain places, like if you want to go to get your account number at certain bank, then what you need to do is first Google it, see the timing of the offices, because here the opening and closing timings are varies, because on Saturday Sundays obviously there is nobody works on Saturday Sundays, like Friday it's something different, Wednesday it's something very different, so you need to know it before going there, because once you go and some they are closing it, so it's like waste going over there, waste of time and as well as energy. So guys, if you want, everybody says that health card is the important thing. First get the health card, but nobody tells you what to do prior to the health card. So what I'll share, because I'm really truly sharing my experience, what happened is I went to get the health card, but nobody told me this, that you need to take some ID proof before that. So then what I have experienced is I need to have some sort of province ID proof. That was totally new to my knowledge. Because of that I'm making this video. One should know what all documents one should carry before going to the places. So the first thing I'll say, address proof. For the health card, the first factor is again the address proof. For bank account, again it will end up with the address proof. So I'll just, the first thing I'll tell you is take the address proof. So how to take the address proof? Suppose if you are staying with your friend and he has already taken, he's on the lease, he's staying there on lease. So just ask him to add your name on the lease papers so that even you will be getting the address proof. So next, photo ID. What is the importance of it? So guys, it is really, trust me, it's really very, very important. And that's what I felt, because I just went twice to the Ontario services for getting my health card, but I didn't got, since I was not having my photo ID there. So the photo ID is really important here, and for getting photo ID, you need to show your passport and next your work permit. That's it. You'll be getting your work permit by paying $35 over there on the Ontario services. So once you get your photo ID, then you can get your this one, health card. So because basically they are asking you for the photo ID. Without that, they will not be providing you any health card over there. So, and the before getting this health card, the photo ID, which you'll be getting within 2 weeks. Your photo IDs you will be getting within 2 weeks, and the after getting you can immediately rush to get the health card. You can provide them your photo ID, your passport, your work permit, and there you go, and you'll be getting your health card within 2 weeks. Okay, and this is how you can get your health card, and the document required for the health card is your photo ID, your passport, your work permit. That's it. No other country, your home, no documents are required of your home countries over here. Just this all documents you require. Next, now opening of the bank account. So guys, what happened is, what we do is we want to open your account, like a home country, we just rush to the bank and we go try to get our we try to give our documents and open the accounts. So it is nothing like this here. You have to take a prior appointment. So before going, just call to the customer care and try to get your appointment set, and then you rush to the bank. So after rushing to your bank, while going to bank, again you need to take your documents, like your passport, your work permit, and then there you go, you'll be getting your bank account done. And and one more thing, an example of mine I'll be giving, I have opened my bank account in Scotia Bank, Yes, they have opened my account that day itself, but next day I got my debit card activated. Means the two times, at least minimum two times, you need to go to the bank. But definitely, whenever you go to some such official paperwork, do carry your all the documents. So the basic document you need to carry to do any work is like any of paperwork. First will be the IDs, that will be the your passport, your work permit, your photo ID. And the last thing one must take is the social insurance number. That is nothing but these people call it like SIN number. This is a very important and this is very personal number. So you should not provide to anybody here unless and until it is necessary to provide. So that thing you need to go and search on the net and where you'll be getting this SIN number. For the SIN number, again, you need to go to the office, like on the Ottawa services office, and there you'll be getting you'll be getting some your appointment. Again, you have to go prior 2 hours prior before doing any kind of paperwork, two hours prior to the offices, and then you have to sign in a queue, and then you have to give your documents like passport, work permit again, and they will hand over you your SIN number depending on your work permit validity. Suppose my work permit validity is going to end at the July 31st, then he will provide again the SIN number valid up to July 31st. So that's how it works. So guys, whenever you're doing any sort of paperwork, carry all the basic documents. So if you feel my video informative, please don't forget to subscribe and stay tuned. Thank you.
Subscribe now and press the bell.